exhibited in the lives of those who are to be honored this evening, for their work of service and devotion to all that is worthy, honorable, and good. We pray that there may never be a lack of such people as these, and that we equally may play our part in the shaping and strengthening of the society of which we are a part. Grant this, O Lord, for the honor and glory of your name. Amen.
This afternoon, I have the honor of escorting our inductees, our prospective inductees, through the school. We went through various classes, interacted with students, talked to teachers. It came to my attention that one of the inductees graduated from Morristown in 1925. So I looked at him, looked at one of my present students, and asked myself the question, where will these students be? Great confidence that many of them will also become inductees into the Hall of Fame. And so what we have this evening, what we see, are bridges to generations of excellence, generations of academic excellence and achievement as characterized by many positive accomplishments of our inductees this evening. But tonight, we're going to meet our future. We're going to meet the students 2025. We're going to acknowledge the outstanding accomplishments, academic accomplishments, of students in grades 10 through 12, most of whom are in the top 10 in grades 10, 11, and 12, top 10 in their classes. They aren't going to find a GPA, most GPAs will work at a 4.0. So they're really outstanding. Now let's meet students. Grade 10.
Barbara Slater. Christian Schoen. Katie Ann Scanlon. Judith Riddell. Pierce Ford.
Thank you. find the program at your feet, I'm sure. Charles, you got your heart up?
Our induction ceremony this evening begins with Morris Teller. Mr. Teller, a member of the summer class of 1925, feeling the economic pressures of the times, was required to work and held at least 3 jobs at a time. Despite this situation, he still found time to be a member of the Latin Club and appear in several school plays. He attended the Philadelphia College of Pharmacy, graduating in 1928, top 10% of his class, and highest marks and honors in operative pharmacy. He took postgraduate work there in chemistry during 1930 and 31, and in 1940 earned a B.S. in pharmacy with a concentration in dermatological pharmacy. In 1925, Mr. Kelly began working in the pharmacy of A.A. Myers in Norristown and purchased that store from Mr. Myers' widow in 1936. The drugstore, Pioneer Medical Supply, as it's now known, has been in operation on DeKalb Street in Norristown for more than 68 years. During this time, he has been a preceptor, a mentor, and a role model to dozens of Norristown students who, after working for him, went on to successful careers in pharmacy, science, education, and business. In 1932, Mr. Cohen married the former Fannie Leah Burr, also a graduate of Norristown High School, summer class of 1926, and began raising a family. During this time, while managing his own store and going to school for advanced degrees, he became the first pharmacist at Montgomery Hospital and an instructor at the hospital's School of Nursing. He served in these capacities for 10 years until 1941. In 1936, Mr. Keller helped to establish the pharmacy department at Sacred Heart Hospital and served as preceptor for their pharmacy interns and is still a consultant to the hospital. Mr. Keller was also a pharmaceutical consultant to Riverview Hospital, the Johnson Home, and Montgomery County Prison, serving their pharmacy needs. He was awarded membership in the American College of Apothecaries in 1959 for pharmaceutical excellence. Mr. Cohen was appointed to serve on the Pennsylvania State Governor's Human Relations Council and advisor to both the Department of Public Welfare and Bureau of Regulatory Committee for Nursing Homes. He was chairman of the Professional Liaison Committee of that board. A member of the Montgomery County Pharmaceutical Association for more than 50 years, he has served as their president, treasurer, and as a board member. Mr. Cohen has been a member of the Norristown Jewish community, Tiferet Beth Israel, for 84 years. He was the honorary B'nai B'rith in 78 for his many years of service. In 1985, he received the Certificate of Honor from the Norristown Jewish community, again for his many years dedicated service. Mr. Cohen was a member of the board of the Jewish Community Center for 15 years and was membership chairman for 12 years. He was the ritual observance officer for 25 years and a lay leader helping to conduct religious services for 45 years. In 1994, he received the Men's Club Achievement and Leadership Award. He is religious chairman for the Men's Club. They established an annual award in his name. Just last month, Mr. Cohen was honored by the Norristown Lions Club as the recipient of the 12th annual M. Eugene Seltzer Humanitarian Award for his meritorious service to the community, his family, his synagogue, and his nation. The Cohens have four children, all graduates of Norristown High School. Dorothy Halevich, class of 52, Dr. Richard Franklin Cohen, 1955, Robert Allen Cohen, 1962, and Stephen Norman Cohen, 1964. Mr. Cohen, please come to the stage at this time to accept your well-deserved award.
I'm Paul Shea here with Mr. Morris Cohen. Mr. Cohen, you graduated from Norristown in 1925. Can you tell us your most fond memories of your years here at Norristown?
My fondest memory, really the pinnacle, it would be to remember our championship football team. And the school closed for a day, and we all boarded the Pennsylvania Railroad train, took us to the University of Pennsylvania, and we played on Franklin Field, I believe it's called. We played Ridley Park for the championship, and we won.
What does induction into the Norristown Hall of Fame mean to you?
It seems to be, I would say, the pinnacle of success.
Presenting Mr. Cohen's award is Dollar Store.
I'm young enough to present. as a young girl, your wife, Fanny, of blessed memory, lived across the street. But then her name was Fanny Pearl. Two of your four children, Dorothy and Richard, were piano students. Several weeks ago, as indicated in your bio, you were honored by the Norristown Lions Club as the 12th recipient of the Unleashing Sovereign Humanitarian Award. You have been active as senior adults of our synagogue. In fact, you have been a model throughout your secular and religious life. Therefore, it is with great joy and honor that I present you in this plaque a permanent record of your induction into the Norristown High School Hall of Fame.
Frederick E. Law, member of the class of 1948, was class president, a charter member of the Key Club, and a member of our team. He also played basketball in Norristown YMCA and Church Lakes. Fred served in the U.S. Navy from 1948 to 1952 on two aircraft carriers, where he was awarded the Korean Service Medal, the European Occupation Medal, and the Navy Good Conduct Medal. Fred received an Associate Degree in Business Administration with a major in accounting from her Sinus College Evening School in 1960. Continuing his education at IBM with extensive training as a processor, Fred had post-high school employment in business with Lee's Cargo of Bridgeport as Vice President of Montgomery County Bank, now Continental Bank, and as Executive Director of the Montgomery County Industrial Development Corporation, and then as President of Rolco Travel, a subsidiary of Rolco Incorporated. In January 1985, the Lobb family purchased the travel company, renamed Lobb Travel, where he currently serves as the Chief Executive Officer and Chairman. Their corporate office is in Malvern, with five branches in two counties. The Lobbs were also original founders of an international travel consortium called CorpNet that after 11 years has sales of $1.5 billion. Lobb, West Orange Township resident, has a long record of public and community service. He is a past president of the Greater Valley Forge Chamber of Commerce and a past chairman of the Central Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce and a current member of the Business Industry School Partnership Program. He served as a West Arden Township Commissioner from 1964 to 1968 and was a member of the Township School Board in 1960 and 61. He helped to organize the Valley Forge Convention and Visitors Bureau of Montgomery County, serving there 18 years, seven as their chairman. Fred helped to organize and serve as the first treasurer of the Hall of Champions Hall of Fame of Norristown High School. Other civic activities include membership in the Kiwanis Club, the Club of Montgomery County, as well as being a member of the advisory board of the Salvation Army. Fred is a past president of the board of directors of the Norristown YMCA and the first president and founder of the Data Processing Management Association of Montgomery County. Currently, he is a trustee of the Historical Society of Montgomery County and a member of the Norristown Rotary. Mr. Lobb has also served as division chairman of the United Fund and as 1974 of the Montgomery Heart Fund. He was honored by the Chapel of the Four Chaplains in 1978 for public service and in 1986 with the Norristown Exchange Club's Golden Deeds Award. Mr. Lobb married his high school classmate, Sarah Jane Henderson, in 1953, and they are the parents of two children, Jeffrey A. Lobb, president of Lobb Travel, and Beth Ann Farley. They have six grandchildren. Would you please come forward at this time to accept your award?
I think the biggest thrill I ever remember from my high school experience was the fact that we had the only state championship boys basketball team in the history of the school. We also performed at the University of Pennsylvania on a Saturday night. Monday morning, we paraded the school with our high school band. And after Miss Christian had an assembly in school for the day, which was terrific. I think it's quite an honor because being recognized by your own local community in some way, and it's difficult, I think, for people to gain recognition in their local area, and that's quite an honor.
Pleasure tonight to present to you Frederick E. Law. Fred and I go back 2 years. Fred has served, was mentioned, as the president of the Greater Chamber of Commerce and as chairman of the Central Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce. Those are both the same organizations. It's not too often that a person comes back to serve again as president of an organization, but when the call was made, Fred was ready and he was willing to volunteer to do it. He was needed. Fred is also the youngest person to serve as president of the Chamber of Commerce. So it didn't take Fred long to get involved within the community and specifically within the business community. Very few opportunities to pass Fred for volunteer
Church. He has been extensively involved in this community. He's very loyal to it. One of the things that I enjoy most about Fred's company is that whenever I'm engaged in conversation with him, I have yet to leave his presence without a new idea. Fred is a bundle of ideas. And if I could implement any idea I heard from Fred, this would be quite a different world. I want to comment on this to his wife, Sarah Jane. You see him much more than I do, and if he has as many ideas with you, it could be quite a joy to live with Fred. But I must say my friendship with Fred had been one of admiration in high school. Hall of Fame. Fred, do that.
Since we moved twice, and all three houses were on Cherry Street. I joined the Navy and finally got good. Dad probably earned about $50 to $60, never owned an automobile, always paid his bills in cash, and never borrowed. Both parents had elementary educations, yet the three boys all found their way through college. The guidance given us in Rick House Junior High and Marshtown High School was our crutch for continuing our education. I clearly remember the career books that Mr. Ulrich had us prepare as a part of that program. Cutting this short, I wish to remember a couple of people who contributed to our education. At Roosevelt Elementary School, I remember Miss Taggart, who was the bell ringer, disciplinarian, and teacher. She would lean out of the window and ring the bell. Boy, would that be a position to price in a teacher's contract today. Mr. Tyson, the janitor, some people might remember him, who kept the school warm and clean and had all those clocks aligned. At Rittenhouse, my mind was Ethel Shelley. I know Mrs. Sturbert, remember her. A dedicated teacher who took the time in our homeroom to teach us to do the two-step so that we could dance at the ninth grade shine and took personal interest in our future. Also, Mrs. Dorothy Selson Stewart, who taught us to enjoy classical music. At NHS, I remember Mr. John Schuler in math class, who told me that I must decide sowing wild oats. And not being a Pennsylvania German, I did not immediately understand. I thank God that we had such devoted and understanding teachers through the school system. I was just a lucky Marstown Cherry Street kid who was given numerous opportunities in this great country. Listened to my teachers, obeyed my parents, married the right girl, adopted by her and my in-laws, stayed close to her, and am thankful for many blessings. When I graduated as class president, we were given the opportunity to speak to your classmates, and I still remember a part of a poem that I used that was framed and hung on my parents' bedroom wall. But once will I pass this way. Any good that I can do, let me do it now, for I will never pass this way again. Thank you, God bless America, and God bless the nation. We're the best team in the land.
Chester County. In 1983,
Holt will return to Norristown as superintendent of schools, serving retirement earlier this year. Dr. Holt is both a leader and a humanitarian. He has touched and enhanced the lives of adults and children alike. His visibility in school buildings, at district events, and at community happenings has brought the leadership of the Norristown Area School District to the public. During his tenure at Norristown, he made significant educational strides, which earned the school state and national recognition. The most memorable recognition, perhaps, was a visit by President George Bush in 1992 to promote his America 2000 program. Norristown had taken the lead with the establishment of the Greater Norristown 2000 program. While an outstanding educator, Dr. Holt's community contributions are measured through the membership in the Rotary Club of Norristown, the Central Montgomery County Chamber of Commerce, the Greater Norristown Corporation, the Boy Scouts of America, the Hello Columbus 1990 Committee, People Caring and Sharing, Life Rescue Mission, and the Business Industry School Partnership Program, to name just a few. He also served for 2 years as Rector's Warden at the Washington Memorial Chapel in Valley Forge. His professional affiliations include the University of Pennsylvania Center for School Study Councils, the Montgomery County School Administrators Association, the American Association of School Administrators, the Institute for Supervision and Curriculum Development, the Pennsylvania Association for School Administrators, and Phi Delta Kappa. Dr. Holton and his wife Mary, who is an associate with Rosa Luth International, reside in Norristown and have two grown children, Mary Catherine and James Damon. They also have two granddaughters. Dr. Holton, we welcome you now to the Norristown Area High School Hall of Fame.
I think my fondest memory was the day that I received notification that I had made first chair of the Southeastern District Band and Orchestra. I later went on to become first chair in the band of the All-State Band in Pennsylvania. The reason that made me so proud and it was such a fond memory is the simple fact that my father was the band director at Norristown at that time. So I was very pleased to have won that honor for myself and for the school district. Norristown has always been a great deal to my family and to me. It's given me the basis for my whole life, and I think it's the greatest school system anywhere. Be honored by being installed in this Hall of Fame, especially with my fellow inductees who have been so distinguished in their careers.
I tonight have known Jim Holt for a lot longer than I have, but the opportunity of working with him for 10 years, secretary and colleague, has provided an insight to know him as the gentleman he is. As a superintendent, he has been highly regarded by his peers and respected by the community, and truly appreciated for his commitment to young people in the district. As a friend, his support and confidence is valued, his judgment respected, and his sense of humor enjoyable. As his co-worker, I have experienced a camaraderie. And have become very familiar with the favorite Jim Holt principle. There are no problems in life, only opportunities to be gained. For many years, Jim was nurtured by the Norristown community, and he has in turn spent a good portion of his career nurturing the Norristown community, not only with his knowledge, but also with his heart. With his moral and ethical example of caring, tolerance, inclusiveness, responsibility, and service, all values which contribute to the welfare of the community. Jim, it's very fitting tonight you are being inducted into the Norristown Area High School Hall of Fame, an acknowledgement of your lifetime of service in the field of education. I believe that James Damon Holt sincerely deserves the honor bestowed upon him tonight, and an honor to present to Jim with this plaque, which serves as a symbol that you're achieving your professional dream.
now an indispensable part of our leadership team in our secondary school district over the past 10 years, is everyone I can think of. I would also like to thank Jim Wood, my good, and Bill McCain, and Nancy Pollyer, Paris Spangler, Bruno Martinelli, and the other officers of the Hall of Fame. This takes a whole lot of work, folks, going for a long period of time, and I cannot tell you how much I appreciate what they have done to honor all of us here this evening. I really appreciate that. His grandfather's footsteps, even more than mine. Of course, my wife's age, my mother's right, but Mary has stuck with me for 35 years of highs, lows, ups and downs, and you name it. And Mary, I cannot say enough, but you have mentored me over the years and has been one of the greatest blessings of my life. The other inductees, I'm very proud to be honored with you this evening, and to make quite a group, I guess, with diverse and all the rest, but again, I feel very humbled to be on this platform. We've had support president, Mary Custer's here tonight, Nancy Huntley, and all the others on the boards of education over the years have made this the best in the country, bar none, in terms of serving the diversity of our community. And I would like to conclude by saying 40 years ago, this coming June, I graduated from Norristown High School. Here's what Mrs. Berger, our guidance counselor 40 years ago, had to say to my class. And ladies and gentlemen of this year's class and next year's class, please listen to these words, because I think that Berger today to you is as much as they were in my class. Mrs. Berger said, if you ever thought of the many changes that have taken place within 12 years as you were working toward this day, you have learned to read and write. You have gained basic knowledge, learning and living. You have participated in government. You have learned consideration and kindness for all people. You have found that you are fortunate to be a citizen of the United States. You have discovered that one cannot live independently, but it takes many people to create community. You have come to believe there's a divine force that makes people a bit better than nationally would be. These changes have made you the young man or woman who is anxious to step into the work included by saying, wherever you go, remember we who are here in the Norristown Area School District wish for you success with the hope that you may be proud of your association here and may ever be proud of you. Mrs. Berger, all I can say is, however proud you may be of our accomplishments, nothing in the world would ever make me prouder than to be able to say that I was a graduate of the Norristown Area School System. Thank you all very, very much.
Mr. Leslie's professional associations include the National
National Electrical Contractors Association, the General Building Contractors Association, and the Subcontractors Association of the Delaware Valley. His awards and honors include being listed as a 1967 edition of Outstanding Young Man in America, the Rotary International Paul Harris Fellowship in 1987, the Greater Norristown JC's Distinguished Service Award, and the Valley Forge Council Boy Scouts of America Distinguished Citizen Award. Married to the former Charlotte Smith, they have one son, Christopher, of Houston, Texas. Mr. and Mrs. Lessig are members of Grace Lutheran Church in Norristown and reside in West North Township. Mr. Lessig, we welcome you now to the Norristown Area High School Hall of Fame.
My memories are the time that I spent with my classmates back then who have become lifelong friends of mine. We used to have a regular group that met for lunch every day and sat at the same table, and even at those tender ages of 16, 17, and 18, we used to try to solve the problems of the world. Having been born and raised in Norristown and lived here all of my life, I've had the privilege to work with members of the Hall of Fame over the years, and to join them tonight is a real thrill for me.
Son, by the way, is a solicitor for the Hall of Champions Association.
went to his class, clad in my gym clothes, and stood before about 25 giggling ninth graders. And he said to me, "Bill, I see that you've chosen the course of general management here." And I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Now, what does a young man who has already had 2 years of algebra expect to learn from a course in general management?" "Well, I don't know. I suppose I learned something." He said, "What do you know about bookkeeping?" I said, "I don't know anything about bookkeeping." He said, "All the more reason you should take it. We will change this from general math to bookkeeping one." I said, "Thank you, Mr. Bill." And left. Well, I can tell you that his concern and his caring for me started me on the career which I enjoy today. Bookkeeping 1 led to Bookkeeping 2, which led to Bookkeeping 3, which led to Accounting 101 and 102 and so on. And introduced me to the world of business where I have earned my living over the past almost 40 years. There were a lot of hard boys in the Marstown School District. Their name might have been Vince Farina, who I see out here tonight, or Frank Schneller, or Chris Pappas, or Addison Allen. And they were always there to keep me pointed in the right direction. Not always an easy task. I'm thankful for all of that. And I'm thankful to all of you for coming out here tonight. If I were to name all of the people that have assisted me over the past 4 decades, I would be here for a very long time. But they know who they are, and I'm grateful to all of them, and I'll never forget them. If I could say one thing to the students here tonight, it would be, wear the blue and white proud. I was proud of Marstown High in 1955, and I'm proud of it today. High schools don't get any better than this. Thank you all very much.
Specific memories that I can recall have to do with the people associated with Norristown High School and Mike at that time. We had a lot of fun in classes related to science and a lot of fun in English classes, just all the classes that we had. plus the social events that went on. And I've been going from the area for quite some time, living in Minnesota for 20-some years, but it's still called Norristown my home to a large degree, and to be recognized with the various other people who have been inducted into the Hall of Fame is certainly something special, particularly...
I just want to also echo how pleased I am to be part of this ceremony tonight and to present Rick. I've known him for a little over 25 years. That happens to be the same time period for which he's being honored tonight with all his accomplishments. Now, it's purely coincidental that I've known him during that same time period. However, during this time period, I've come to know him as a brother. And technically, that's probably true because 25 years ago, I married a sister. The Rick that I have known and loved over these years has proved to be a very loyal son and a supportive brother, a generous uncle, and a very good friend to many, many people. In fact, the only fault that I can find with him is where he chooses to live. Duluth, Minnesota. It's a lovely place to visit, but it is very, very far from home. Home, I think, still being Norris. He still likes tasty cakes, Philly steaks. He still roots for the Eagles. And I think even after last night, he's probably still a Phillies fan. I hope he is. I guess the best thing that I can say about Rick, the thing that probably describes him more than any other, is that he's many people. As to why an old man like yourself would do such a thing and waste your time, what's in it for you? And he stops and he answers one of his critics and says, in the words of the poet, "There follows there for me today a youth whose feet must pass this way." This chasm happens not for me to that fair-haired lad, may a pitfall be, for he too must cross in the twilight dim. Good friend, I'm building this bridge for him. I salute the other inductees and also Rick, because they have spent a lifetime following graduation from Norristown High School as bridge builders. Bridges for others to cross, either in the past or in the future. And so I present to you Dr. Richard J. Zager, one of Norristown's finest bridge builders.
Values that were instilled in me during my formative years when I was young, growing up here in Norristown at the school and with the friends that I've made here. Certainly one cannot single out lots and lots of people, but I do have to mention my mom and dad, who during the course of my growing up were particularly influential, kept saying, go to school, go to graduate school, get a good education, which I tried to do. They never could quite understand how I could continue to study for exams the night before with the radio on, and how I could still manage to pull half decent grades. I managed to do school, but when college came around, it was a bit more difficult than that. Fortunately, for the younger people here, if you want something hard enough and you're willing to work for it, you can usually come up with it. So for the values that my mom and dad and the rest of the Ziegler and the immediate family instilled upon me, I thank them very much. Many of my aunts and uncles are sitting out there now, and I can't say enough about them and their support that they've given me over the years. I think what I also have to mention in terms of values is that the teachers at Norristown High, and the teachers here are excellent. They continue to be. There's a tradition of excellence here. I couldn't figure out for the life of me when I was a student here what good being able to diagram a sentence was going to help me in my English classes, but I can tell you 100% for sure that being able to recognize misplaced modifiers and dangling participles and putting sentences together is extremely important what your career is, because most people begin their communications by writing, and one of the things that impresses other individuals about your ability is that you can put a sentence together and it makes sense and it's properly constructed. So for the English that I learned here, for the study in biology with Art Herb, who I'm sure most of you all know, and his antics and activities down at the zoo, and his in-class activities, certainly were very influential in my life. There are other classes that I've had that are influential. I can remember a German class with Herr Long. Herr Long took a terrible ribbon from the classes, but he's from the students in his class, but he stuck to his goals, and he taught us some German. Actually, after I thought about it several years ago when I did travel to Germany. I hadn't used German for a number of years, but I still managed to remember a few lines that I could speak. Unfortunately, not all of them were related to the Tannenbaum, which we used to sing in German every Christmas class that we had. But the tradition of excellence in the teachers and the values that they instilled upon me were certainly very influential. And of course, then there's the friends and colleagues that one develops over the years. And I think if I have any particular message to the students is listen to your friends and colleagues and learn from them. In conclusion, I would have to say that one of the unique features of having an education in the Norristown area is that this is a diverse school district. You are a diverse education. You are also put in contact in a very diverse environment. Culturally and socially, lots of different things are happening. It's not strictly one perspective or another perspective. And I think as you grow up and graduate from here, move on to college or your profession, you'll be able to appreciate the perspectives given to you by your teachers and by your colleagues in classes. You'll learn different perspectives and begin to appreciate them. You won't be a person who's very narrow-minded. So I thank my teachers and colleagues that I've had in the past here at Norristown High. It certainly was a memorable experience for me. I learned a lot. When asked by one of the student interviewers today what my most memorable memory of Norristown High was, it was difficult to bear one specific memory. But what I do remember is the people, the teachers, the classmates, and the fellow athletes, fellow students that I spent lots of time with. They're all good people. They were very great. They learned a lot from them. I appreciated the time here. And certainly when you move from this area to another area, you begin to gain more perspective on what you've learned from the contact early in life. So I know that there is indeed a World Series game going on. I do remain a loyal Phillies fan, in spite of many of the Minnesota Twins fans that I have in the Midwest. So I will conclude my comments and thank you all once again for coming. It's been my pleasure to be here. It's certainly a privilege to accept this honor. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, guys, for having me.